What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Drawn Outdoors TV. Today we are going to cover tree stand audio. So no matter what you're using, whether you're using an internal mic or an external mic, whether it's low end or high end, we're going to talk about audio. I'm going to tell you a specific mic you can get for really cheap that's going to get the job done for you. But most importantly, I'm going to show you in the editing process how to fix your bad audio, how to make it sound really good even with a cheap microphone, so that way everybody can understand you in the tree. Nobody wants to watch a video where they can't hear a single word the person is saying. So we're gonna make sure that doesn't happen. We're gonna make sure it's nice and clear and sounds really good. So let's dive in. And just to clarify, this isn't just for tree stand audio. This is just for any audio you're doing in general, whether it's for hunting or something else. You can do this in a big box blind, a ground blind, a tree stand, a saddle, whatever the fact, whatever, a saddle. Yeah, you're in a tree with a saddle. Whatever you're gonna be doing, this is just a good way to make your audio sound better. This is the microphone that I use the most, right here. This is the Rode Video Micro. It costs like 50 bucks. It's not a very expensive microphone. It's actually pretty cheap, but you can get really good audio from it. And it's a non-powered microphone, so you just gotta make sure that your camera can accept a non-powered microphone. Your camera has to be the one that powers it. If you need a battery-powered microphone for your camera, you have to look for something different, in like a Video Mic Pro or something like that. But this right here for 50 bucks is really hard to beat. A good lav mic is gonna be your best option for audio when it comes to talking, but you can get away with one of these really well and you honestly wouldn't be able to tell a difference. So let's check it out. All right, so I've got the same clip here twice. I've got, I already just threw a LUT on them real quick that I use. It's the same exact clip. Right now, currently, neither one has been messed with at all. So I'll leave the first clip the way it is, and then the second clip, I'm gonna put the audio adjustments on there that I do, and then I'll explain how I do those. So, second clip here in Final Cut Pro 10, I'm gonna go over here to the video and audio. I'm gonna go down to audio. I already made a new setting for this. That's gonna be down here. I put it in as tree stand audio just for this tutorial. So all I'm gonna do is drag and drop right on it, and it's gonna make the adjustments all for me because I already have all the settings in place for it. So you can see how it completely changed all of the EQ and levels compared to what it is originally. I made sure I wasn't quite peaking on anything, and I'll explain why I do that and why I have it set this way. So up over here, if you click on the audio, you'll see I've raised the volume of it, which you could do to the original clip and just leave it as just raising the volume audio. But I'll show you why I don't just do that. So there's a new feature now called voice isolation in Final Cut Pro. This is a pretty recent one. It hasn't been very long. And so what it does is it just isolates the talking that's in the audio. So it will basically crush all the other sounds. So if it's like windy out or there's a bunch of background noise of any sense, it will just basically cut all that out. And so you can adjust how strong you want to be. Basically, usually anywhere between 50 and 75% is really good, and it cuts a ton of the audio out. So I'll make sure to show you an example of that. Next, I run a channel EQ. You can open the parameters. I already have a preset made. And then what I'll do is I'll go through and I'll move some of these around. Basically, your voice audio is gonna be anywhere from like 1,000 to like 1,500 or 1,700 or something like that. That's usually pretty much the voice range. So you can adjust that up and down. Then you can also crush some highs and some lows if you need to. So if your highs are too high or need to come down a little bit, you can do that. Same with the bass. So it kind of depends on the audio. Next thing I would do is I put on a limiter. So that way, if it is peaking in some spots, this limiter will bring down the little parts that's peaking. So that way I don't peak and have any bad audio. And then I also have a compressor. This is the compressor settings that I run. The compressor helps to take the audio from being quiet or loud, and it brings it all together. So basically compresses it all kind of in the middle is what it tries to do. It brings up the lows and crushes the highs. It definitely helps give you a lot more gain in your audio, so it definitely brings things up a lot. So that's one a huge thing that I would definitely recommend doing. All these settings that I have for this, I got this from a guy named Serge M. He's another YouTuber that does a bunch of tutorials, and this was the settings that he did for his compressor, and I literally have never changed them since, and they work great. So I'm not too too in-depth on that type of stuff. So once I find something that works, I just kind of stick with it. So these are all the settings that I have for that. If you want to screenshot this or do whatever and just put exactly the same, or go to Surge M and check out his channel on his audio for the compressor. All right, so let's play through this real quick. This is the first clip with no audio adjustments at all to it.
But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area.
Okay, so that's the first clip with no adjustments to it. Here is the second clip with all the adjustments to it.
But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area.
So you can see right away how much better it is. It's a lot louder, it's a lot clearer, a lot more crisp. It crushes down some of that wind audio and some of the background. So it makes a huge difference, and this is just with a cheap microphone, and you can still get that really good audio that you really wouldn't think you're gonna get from a cheap microphone. But just making those little adjustments make a huge difference on making sure people can understand what you're saying while you're in the tree stand. So let's listen to it straight through one more time. So this is gonna be the first clip with no audio adjustments at all, and then the second clip with all the adjustments to it.
But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area. But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area.
First thing I did though is I went in and did the voice isolation, add the channel EQ, the limiter, and the compressor, and then from there, that's when I'll adjust the volume to go up or down if I need to. So I always do that, and one thing that's really cool is once you get kind of your settings all pretty much set with the effects that you want, then you can go down to the save effects preset, and you can actually save this, and it'll literally have this exact full setup, and you just throw that straight onto your clip, and then you're good to go, just like that, and it's done. Now you don't have to mess with it. Sometimes you have to adjust something minor depending on the situation of the clip, but for the most part, you're gonna be way faster, it's gonna speed up your editing, and it's gonna sound way better right off the get-go. You can find all of these audio adjustments in the audio here. You just kind of scroll through. I use the channel EQ right here up top. I have it up there. And then I use the limiter, which is going to be right here. The compressor that I use is actually down here. It's the Logic compressor, and that is right here. So those are the three things I use pretty much on every audio I ever do. I use pretty much those three things. And now with this new voice isolation thing, it's really cool. I'll show you what it sounds like with the voice isolation and without the voice isolation. So this is gonna be without voice isolation.
But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area. But we've been getting some pictures of quite a few deer back here. We had a decent snowstorm about a week ago, and then a really bad thunderstorm, a bunch of tornadoes in this area.
Notice how much noise there is in the background. And obviously I would probably lower my levels here because it's got all the extra noise, so it's peaking a little bit. But you notice just the background noise, that white noise, and the little bit of wind there. And then you turn the voice isolation on, and it completely gets rid of that. So that's a super awesome feature that Final Cut Pro 10 has. I would guess that some of the other softwares like Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve probably have something similar to that. This is a pretty new thing that Final Cut Pro 10 just added not that long ago, and it's definitely a super cool feature that I'm gonna be using a lot in the future. So make sure to check that out if you use Final Cut Pro 10, or check out what your softwares have in them. This should hopefully help you get way better audio while you're out hunting, so that way people can understand what you're saying, and it's not just a bunch of mumbling and people have no idea, and then they just wanna scroll through because they can't hear you. So hopefully this helps. We're about 36 days away here in Nebraska from deer hunting opener. We're getting amped. Hope you guys are getting excited. Hopefully this helps you out. If it did, leave us a comment below. If you have any questions, let me know. If I screwed something up, you can let me know that too, because it doesn't hurt my feelings. I'm not perfect. I'm not the complete expert on everything. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe. We'll see you next time.